हेलो, इज इट ऑडिबल? हेलो,
यस सर।
या सॉरी फॉर द डिले, वी हैड अ स्लाइट नेटवर्क इश्यूज। ओके, सो रिगार्डिंग लास्ट क्लास, वी वर डीलिंग विद फर्स्ट इन फर्स्ट आउट एल्गोरिदम। ओके, सो वी हैड दिस फर्स्ट इन फर्स्ट आउट पॉलिसी where I'll be selecting or I'll be replacing the page which has arrived first in the queue. So this first in first out will be operating similar to the queue. Okay, so the victim page will be selected based upon the arrival time. So the page which has arrived first in the queue, that will be replaced first. Or in other words, you select the oldest page. Okay, so based upon this an examination, like they'll be giving you some sequence of strings. Okay, like these are called as the page reference string. Okay, and these pages will be requested by the CPU. Okay, so upon this sequence of strings, like you need to construct this particular table. So where we have the pages, right? Is it visible, all of you? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so we have the list of pages here, starting from 3, 2, 1, 3, 4, 1, etc. So we have a process that's been divided into these many pages, and we have been asked, like in the problem, so the allotted number of frames in the physical memory or main memory or RAM is three number of frames have been allocated, and those are F1, F2, and F3. Okay. So you can start allocating the frames for the individual pages, okay, right? And we have this last row, right? Like, so as to indicate whether the page is available in the physical memory or in the main memory or not. Suppose if the page is available in the main memory, okay, so then that can be called as a hit, okay, a page hit. Suppose if the page is not present in the physical memory, that can be called as a page miss or page fault. Okay, so let us start with solving the problem, right? So the first page is three, okay, and as we know that the three is not available in the physical memory, hence I can store this three in the frame number one. Okay, and what about the availability of page? Is it a page hit or a page fault? It's a page fault, X. So we can indicate that page fault as X, or I can like also call it as a page miss. Okay, yeah. So now coming to the second page. Okay, so whether we have the second page in the physical memory, answer me. Hello?
No.
No. So then that indicates that is a page miss. Okay, or a page fault has occurred. Hence, I'll be storing this page number two in which frame? Second frame. Okay, so in second frame, I'll be storing this page number two. Okay, and still we are remaining with the one empty frame, and that is F3. Okay, so now coming to this third page. Third page is page one. Okay, so as we have here empty frame, right, I can store this page one in frame number three. And what about the remaining pages three and two are stored in page number, I mean, frame number F1 and frame number F2. Okay, so we have this also as the page fault has occurred because this page one not there in the physical memory. So now coming to this fourth page. Okay, so the fourth page is page number three. Okay, and if you see this available frames, no frames are available right now. Why? Because all the frames F1, F2, F3 have been occupied by page number three, page number two, page number one. All right. Yeah. So now the next page is three. So what about this status of the like memory location in the RAM? So whether this page is available in the RAM? Yes. So we have here.
Okay.
Yeah. So we have the page number three that is stored in frame number one. Hence, this can be called as a page hit. Okay, so you can represent that like using this H letter. Okay, so you can go for a use of the capital letter H, or you can simply like simply use a right mark. Okay, so suppose if I have a page hit, means no need to replace any page in the frame. Hence, what should enter here? What
three.
Should be? Yeah, 3. And in frame number 2, 2. And in frame number 1, I mean frame number 3, same one. Same one will be stored. Okay. Yeah. So now again coming to the frame, I mean next page. Next page is what? 4. Next page is 4. And again, we don't have this particular page in the physical memory. Hence, it is corresponding to a page fault. Hence, you can put an X here. Okay. So this X indicates what? X indicates that this particular page 4 is not currently available in the physical memory. Hence, which page to replace? Like among the page 3 and page 2 and page 1, which page to replace? And according to the FIFO policy, the oldest page should be replaced. And for that, so what I have a small logic keys. Okay, you can just see the starting point of these pages. Page number 3, you can see the starting point is here. And the starting point of page number 2 is somewhere here. And the starting point of page number 1 is somewhere here. So suppose if you see the starting point of page number 3, 2 and 1, the oldest page is obviously
3.
Page number 3. Hence, here you can replace this page number 3 with a new page. Here, new page is
4.
Okay. Hence, this 3 is replaced by a new page 4. And what about these two frames? Like in these two pages, two and one remains as it is. Yeah. Okay. Right. So now coming to the next page. Next page is page number 1. Okay. So again, we have page hit or page miss. Why? Because like this page 1 is already available in frame number 3. Hence, you have a page hit. So once we have a page hit, means no need to replace any of the pages. Hence, what should you write here? 4, 2, 1. All right. Fine. So what about next? Next page is page number? Page number 6 it is. And this page number 6 is not available in the frames, like either F1 or F2 or F3. Hence, we can call this as a page fault. Okay. And again, you can see the starting point of this page number 2 and starting point of the page number 4 and page number 2 and page number 1. So according to this, starting point of page number 4 is here, starting point of page number 2 is here, starting point of page number 1 is here. And I can see that this page 2 is the oldest page. Hence, I can replace this with the 6. And what about this frame 1? Frame 1 stores again the 4. And what about this page number, frame number F3? 1. Yeah. So again, going to the next page. Next page is page number 2. And I can see that this page is not available in the main memory. Hence, it is a
page fault.
Exactly right. So suppose if it is a page fault, means which page has to be replaced here? Again, starting point of 4 is here. A starting point of 6 is rightly here. Starting point of 1 is somewhere here. So the oldest page here is 1. Hence in F3, okay, so this 1 is replaced by 2. And what about this 4 and 6 in frame F1 and F2? Those are maintained as it is. Exactly right. So now coming to the next page. Next page is 4. Okay. And what about the condition status of the page?
Hit.
So this is a hit. Why? Because? Why? Sorry. Why? Because? So this 4 is all. So this 4 is already available here. Right? So this page is already available. Hence for that, no need to replace any of the pages. All right. Is it right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So next page is page 3. So this page 3 is not available, hence it is a page fault or a page missed cities. And again, you can see which page to replace, right? Starting point of 4 is here, starting point of 6 is somewhere here, starting point of 2 is here itself. So which page has to be replaced?
4.
So like in place of 4, like I'll be writing 3 here. And what about this field 6, this field 2. So again, so next page is 4. Next page is 4. So for that, whether it is a hit or a miss,
fault.
Its page fault is there. Hence, I'll be entering X here. And which page to be replaced? Starting point of 3 is right here. 6 is here and 2 is here. So 6 should be replaced with 4. Exactly four. Right. So what right here?
3
and here?
2.
Exactly right. So next page, next page is 2. And what about the status? It is a
hit.
Why hit? Because this page 2 is present in the frame 3. Hence, it is a hit. Okay. So once we have a hit, means no need to replace any of the pages. Okay. So what about this next page? Next page is 1. And we have a page fault. Hence, I need to enter X. Right. So once we have a page fault, which page needs to be replaced? Starting point of 3 is 2. Here. Starting point of 4 is here. So 2 is replaced with
1.
And this is 4. And this is 3. Yeah. So next page is 4. And as you can see that, this 4 is available in the frame number 2. Hence it is a
hit.
Is it a hit?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yeah, it is a hit. Hence, I'll be entering H here. And once we have a hit, means no need to replace any of the page. Hence, I'll be entering 3 here. I'll be entering 4 here. I'll be entering 1 here. So next page is 5, right? And this 5 is not there in the main memory. Hence, it is a page fault. Exactly right. Okay. So once we have a page fault, means again, see starting point of 3 is here, starting point of 4 is here, starting point of 1 is here. Hence, the oldest page is page number 3. Hence, here, what should be entered?
5.
Here, 4. Here, 1. So next page is page number 2. Page number 2 is not there. Hence, it is a page fault or a page miss. Okay. Hence, which page has to be replaced?
4.
Starting point of 4 is
4.
Here. Yeah. So 2, 5, 1. So again, page number 1 is available in the frame number 3. Hence, it is a page hit. Hence, no need to replace any of the page. Hence, I'm entering here 5, 2, 1 as it is, no change. Hence, next page is 3 and page number 3 is not present. Hence, it is a
page fault.
Again, see which page has to be replaced.
One.
Why? Because it is the oldest page, like among the page 5, 2 and 1, the starting point of 1 is far away. Okay, hence I can enter this 1 with the 3 and in frame 2, 2 and in frame 1, 5. Yeah, so the last page will be page number 4 and this page is not there in the memory. Hence that is a page fault and you can see which page to be replaced. Starting point of 5 is here, 5. Starting point of 2, 5 starting point of 5 you can replace with the 4 and 2 and 3 remains as it is. Okay. So the logic here is you just remember this bracket, like is it visible bracket square? Power bracket. Okay. So this indicates the oldest page and you can see the starting point of the pages and you can simply replace the oldest page. Okay, a small clue that can be used in the examination so as to fill these frames with these pages. Okay, so once we select enter all the frames, okay, so the next thing is to calculate the number of page faults. So to calculate the number of page faults, simply you count the number of cross marks x. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So we have how many page faults? 13. Yeah.
13.
So, exactly. So what is the hit ratio? How many hits we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we have 6 as the hit ratio. I mean, so we have 6 as the number of hits. Okay. And to find the hit ratio, what we can do is we can just divide the hit number divided by the number of pages, right, in a process. And here we have how many pages of a process? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19 pages we have, right? So you can divide 6 divided by 19 so as to calculate the hit ratio, right? And what about miss ratio? You just calculate the number of page faults or number of misses, okay? And you can just divide it by number of pages. Okay, so here, I mean, what is it? 6 divided by 9 is hit ratio and 13 divided by 19 is miss ratio. So here ends the problem based upon first in, first out algorithm. Is that clear? Here, main thing is to remember this so-called flow brackets. Okay, and you can have a clue that you should be able to see the starting point of each and every page, and the oldest page will be replaced with a new page. All right, are we clear with this?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so next thing is something called as a Bilady's. Tell me. Hello,
sir. Table is the address, sir.
Table again. I need to come one more time. Okay, so I'll deal with this one more time. Okay, like I'll delete all the pages. Yeah, so here are the number of pages of a process. Okay, so we have a process P. That process P is been divided into how many pages? Just count this.
19.
Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19 number of pages are there. And we have been given with how many frames? 3 frames, F1 frame, F2 frame and F3 frames are the 3 frames, okay? Like 3 blocks available in the main memory, okay? So, like all these are the the frames available in the main memory, and all these pages will be present in the logical memory. Okay, so you go on allocating these pages into these frames. Okay, and we need to calculate the number of page faults or number of page miss and the number of page hits, as well as the hit ratio and the miss ratio. Okay, so for that, like as we have here available 3 number of frames, I can allocate the first page in the first frame. Hence, I'll be entering here. Which page?
3.
Page number 3. Third. Yeah. Right. So again, like as this 3 is not available in the main memory, hence that can be called as a page miss or a page fault. Okay. So next, going to the next page. Okay. Like as we have here 2 more free frames, hence this page number 2 can be allocated to the frame number 2, and 3 is as it is. Okay. Again, this is also a page miss. Why? Because the page 2 is not available in any of these frames. Okay. So next, page 1. Okay. So here, again, here we have one more free frame. Okay. So called F3. Is available as free. Hence, I can enter this one here And this is also a page fault because this page one is not available in the main memories. And what about this frame two and frame one? They'll be occupying this page three and page two respectively. Okay. Yeah. So now coming to the fourth page. Okay. Right. So the fourth page is page number three. Right. And like as you can see this, so this page number three is already available in the frame number F1. Hence, we call this as a page hit. Okay. So once we have a page hit means no need to replace any of the pages. Hence, I'll retain these pages as it is, no change in it. Okay. So, but you can indicate that using this H, right? H stands for horse.
Hit.
Page hit.
Yeah, page hit. Right. So next is this page number four is there. Okay. And this page number four is not available in the physical memory. Hence, it is a page miss or a page fault. Okay. Page fault. And here you see which page has to be replaced. So for that, I have like indicated a small queue. Okay. Like using this clever bracket. So you can see the starting point of page number three, page number two, and page number one. And whichever page has a like is the oldest page or the page like which is at the MSB position, most MSB position, okay, that page needs to be replaced. So for example, suppose if I look at the starting point of page number three means like it is here, and starting point of page number two is here, right? Here it is, and page number one is here. Okay, so for that, the oldest page among 3, 2, 1 number of pages is page number three, right? Hence, I can replace this page number three with a new page, that is
four.
Okay, and frame two and frame three will contain the similar pages. Okay, so now coming to this next page is one, and we have this one already available in frame number three, hence it is a page hit. Okay. So once we have a hit means no variation, no change. Okay. Right. So you can retain the same pages in the same frames, no change because we have a hit here. Right. Are you following?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So next page is page number six. So page number six is not rightly present in the frames. Hence it is a
page fault.
Yeah. Hence it is a page fault. Now you see the starting point of this page number four and page number two and page number one. You can see that the page number one is, page number two is the oldest page. Hence you can replace this two with page number six, and I can retain page number one and page number three as four and one. Okay. No change in them. Fine. So like, what is the next page?
Two.
Yeah. So next page is page number two. And this is obviously a page fault because this page two is not there in the physical memory, right? Hence it is a page fault or a page miss. Now you see which page needs to be replaced. Huh? Starting point of four is here. Starting point of six is rightly here. Starting point of page number one is here. Hence, which page needs to be replaced? Page number one. Yeah. And six and four remains as it is. Fine. Haley. Hello. Hello. Excuse me, are you there?
Yes, sir.
You need to speak, all of you. You should answer me. You should speak. Right. So what is the next page?
Four.
Next page is four. And this four is available in the physical memory. Hence, what I should be entering here? It's a page hit. Okay. Right. So once we have a page hit means no need to change any of the pages. No need to replace any of these pages. Hence, 4, 6, and 2 are written as it is. No change. Okay. So what about next page?
Page fault.
Yeah. So next page is 3 and we have an obvious page fault is there. Hence, I need to go for replacement. Now you see the starting point of 4 is here. Okay. Starting point of 6 is here. And starting point of page 2 is here. Now the oldest page is here.
4.
Hence, this 4 is replaced with page number 3. And what about 6 and 2? 6 and 2 are retained as it is. Next page is 4. Again, we have a page fault here because this page 4 is not there in the physical memory. Hence, it is a page fault. Now we see which page needs to be replaced.
6.
Yeah. And it's page number 3 and 2 are maintained as it is. Yeah. So next for page number 2. So this page number 2 is there already in which frame? Frame number F3. Okay. Hence it is
page hit.
Okay. And so once we have a hit means no need to replace any of the pages. Okay. So next is page number 1. And this 1 is not present in the physical memory. Hence it is a page miss or page fault. Now you see starting point of 3, 4 and 2. Which one has to be replaced?
2.
Starting point of 2 is far away when compared to the starting point of 4 is here and 3 is here. Hence you can replace page number 2 with page number
1.
And 3 and 4 remains as it is. So next 4. So this 4 is already available. Hence it is a
page hit.
Okay. So once we have a page hit means no need to replace any of the pages. Fine. So next is page number 5. And page number 5 is not there physically present. Hence it is
page X.
Yeah. Page fault is there. And which page needs to be replaced?
3.
Why 3? Because the starting point of 3 is far away. Okay. When compared to this 4 and this 1, hence I can replace page number 3 with 5. And this 4 and page 1 remains as it is. What about this page number 2? Page number 2 is not there. Yeah, we have a page fault. And which page? 4, right?
4.
Yes.
4. And this 5 and 1 remains as it is. So next, what about 1?
Page hit.
Yeah. So we have a page hit and no need to replace any of the page. Simply retain those pages as it is. No change in it. Next is the page number 3. And page number 3. So we have a page fault. Hence, which page needs to be replaced?
One.
Yeah. And 2 and 5 remains as it is. What about 4? 4 is also a page fault. Yeah. So again, you see the starting point of 5, 2 five. And 3. Yeah, 5 needs to be replaced. Yes. 4, 2, 3. Exactly right. Okay. So once we have the filling of all the pages in the respective frames, next thing is, in the examination, they will ask you to calculate the number of page faults or the number of page miss and also the number of hits, right? Along with you also calculate the hit ratio and the miss ratio. Okay. So you can simply count the number of page faults and the number of hits. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13 are the number of misses, right? Or the page faults. Okay. Similarly, number of hits. Simply count the number of H. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Is that right? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Sir.
Right. So once you count the number of miss and number of hit means you can calculate hit ratio. So what is the formula for calculation of hit ratio? Number of hits divided by total number of pages. Okay. And it is 6 divided by 19. So what about miss ratio? Miss ratio is nothing but number of page faults divided by total number of pages. That is 19. Okay. So there ends the problem. Right. So once we are done with the calculation of number of hits and number of faults and number of hit ratio and miss ratio. Okay. So we have a problem. Okay. In the first in first out policy, right. Especially in the first in first out policy. Okay. And that is called as a Bilyadis anomaly. Okay. So we have here a problem, right. So which is predominant in first in first out policy, and that we call it as Bilyadis anomaly. Okay. So what is the concept here is, say normally what we believe is, suppose if I have the increase of number of frames here, okay. Suppose if I increase the number of say frames from 3 number of frames to 4 number of frames, then what we normally expect is to have the reduction in the page fault. Why? Because like we are made available with one more free frame, so-called F4 frame. Hence, what we expect normally is to have the reduction in the number of page faults. Okay. So like, but this is not always true. Okay. Means what? As I increase the number of page frames, the faults will not decrease. Okay. Instead, you may have the increase in the number of page faults, even though we are increasing the number of frames. Okay. So this anomaly, we call it as Bilyadis anomaly. Is that clear? So normally what we believe is, as I increase the number of frames, okay, we normally expect that the number of page faults must decrease, but this statement is not always true. Okay. Right. Hence, in some sequence of strings, we find that even though we had increased the number of frames, so but still we'll be having the increase in the number of page faults. This is called as Bilyadis anomaly. Okay. So we do have an increase in the page faults, even upon increase in the number of page frames. This phenomena is called as Bilyadis anomaly. And this occurs in which policy?
First in, first out.
Yeah, first in, first out. And it is not found in LRU. LRU stands for least recently used, right? And optimal replacement algorithms. Only this Bilyadis anomaly is found only in the first in, first out page replacement algorithm. Okay. So you can see the example here. Okay. So we have here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 number of pages. So you can go on entering the table. Okay. So you can tell me the answer. So what about this? It's page 1. Just a minute. Let me go for, yeah. So here, so we have a page fault. Why? Because page number 1 is not present.
No.
So again, it's page number 2. Again, page fault. Hence, I can store this page number 2 in frame number 2. What about page number 3? Also a page fault. Hence, this page number 3 is stored in frame number 3. So what we are doing here is, right? Here I'm explaining that. Suppose if I have 1, 2, 3 number of frames. And suppose if you have 1, 2, 3, 4 number of frames, say for the same number of pages, okay, let's say, let us analyze the number of faults and the number of hits, okay. Suppose if I have the increase in number of frame numbers, means whether we are having an increase or decrease in the number of faults, okay. So that we are analyzing here, okay. So by taking the same pages, okay. So, but the main variation here is, like in the first case, the number of frames are 3, and in second case, number of frames are
4.
And usual tendency is, suppose if I increase number of frames from 3 frames to 4 frames, means what we expect, what we desire is, I should be able to have reduction in the number of page faults. Okay. So, but that is not true always. Okay, and that we call it as, which problem is this? Yeah, Bilyadis anomaly. Okay, yeah. So what about the next page? Next page is 4, right? And this this 4 is not available here. Hence, it is a
page fault.
Yeah. So now we see the starting point of 1, 2, and 3. So which place has to be replaced?
1.
Yeah. Yeah. So 2 and 3 remains as it is. So next is page number 1. Page number 1 is not there. Hence,
page
it is
fault.
Yeah, page fault. So which page has to be replaced?
Two.
Yeah, right. 4 and 3. Is it right? Fine. So next page is 2. Next page is 2. Yeah. So we have a page fault. Hence, you enter X first. Okay. And then you can search for the pages which has to be replaced.
Three.
Yeah. 3.
Two.
1. 4. Okay. So next is page number 5. So we have a
page fault.
Yes.
Fault.
So which page has to be replaced?
4.
4. Exactly right. 1 and 2. So what about page number 1?
Page hit.
Page hit. Why? Because we have this page number 1 already present in which frame? Frame number 2. Wow. So once I have a hit means no need to change any of the pages. Am I right? Yeah.
Yes, sir.
So what about next page? Next page is 2. Again, it is a
page hit.
Again, it is a hit.
Hit.
Yeah. So once I have a hit, same statement, no need to have any replacement. Okay. So next is page number 3. And this is a page fault. Yeah. And which place replace?
2. 1.
2.
1. 1.
1 because one. The starting point of 1 is far away from starting point of 2, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So hence I can replace page 1. Right. So next page, 4. 4 is not available. We have a page miss here or a page fault. So which page needs to be replaced?
2.
Page number 2. Why? Because starting point of page number 2 is here and starting point of page number 5 is here. Okay. So hence you can have this as the oldest page. Hence page 2 is replaced. Yeah. Next, last one.
Page hit.
Page hit. Why? Because 5 is available in the frame number 1. Hence, since it is a hit, no need to have any sort of page replacement. Right. So now count the number of faults and hits. Number of faults are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So we have 9 number of page faults or page miss. So what about number of hits?
3.
Yeah. 3. Is it right?
Yes.
Okay. So now what we do is, I'll just increase the number of frames by how many? By 1. Wow. Like in the earlier case, you had number of frames as 3. So, but now I'm doing the same replacement policy for same number of pages by having one more extra frame. Okay. So suppose if you do this means I will be having number of page faults as 10. And number of hits as 2. Number of hits as 2. Okay. Like in this case, you can analyze what we have done here. Even though we have increased the number of frames, so but still the number of page faults are lesser, more?
More.
3.
Yes. Yes. Number of page faults are more here. Okay. Why? Because in the earlier case, so we had the number of faults as 9. Okay, so but even though we had increased the number of frames by 1, so but still we have one more extra fault. Okay, right? So this we call it as delayed is anomaly. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
So what about these empty frames? Who will fill this? Who has to fill this?
We.
Now I feel muddy. You analyze by yourself, right? Like it's very easy, na? Okay. Simply remember this, what do you call this? Flower bracket, na? And I can analyze starting point of each and every page and I can just replace the oldest page. That's it. Nothing more than that. So it's very easy. Okay. So we have hardly left with 1 minute. Within that, let me cover this.